Good 10, Wisconsin's first heart transplant took place 50 years ago at St. Luke's. And 5 decades later, transplant patients have a much better chance of survival. Our Ricky Mitchell talked to a doctor and patient about the surgical advancements.
Doctors at this hospital perform 25 to 30 heart transplants each year. That's twice as many as the majority of transplant programs in the world. And now with medical advancements, patients are expected to survive, which was not the case in 1968.
When Gary Leo's heart condition started to rapidly decline, he was forced to stop practicing as a neurologist.
You know, it's hard to say what the outlook would have been, but I would expect to have died within the course of 2 to 3 years.
He was put on the transplant list in January, and in June, he got the call.
Because I didn't expect to get the heart this quickly. I think you have kind of a sense that you've gotten, you know, a second chance, and you need to, you know, give back and do something positive.
50 years ago, when doctors at St. Luke's performed the first heart transplant in the Midwest, it was not as common to survive.
The unique part of Betty Anik, who was our recipient here at St. Luke's, was she lived the longest of the early cohort of those patients in the United States.
Downey says new medication developed in the 80s greatly improved outcomes.
Suppressing the immune system back in 1968 was essentially non-existent. It was pretty much if the recipient tolerated the organ or not.
Where do you see the surgery going 50 years from now?
Well, we're trying to improve tolerance, meaning that if we can use fewer drugs and less amounts of drugs to prevent rejection, that the patients will live even longer.
Dr. Downey says there never seems to be enough donors to meet that need, and he encourages those who are interested in organ donation to have conversations with their families. Reporting outside Aurora St. Luke's, Ricky Mitchell, today's TMJ4.
And at least 50% of heart transplant patients will live more than 12 years, and many patients have survived more than 20 years. That is incredible.
Great success there.